Good morning students, welcome to Organic Reaction Mechanism class. In this class you are learning about two reactions, that they are hydroxylation at an aromatic carbon. Hydroxylation at an aromatic carbon, and the second one is Reed reaction. These two topics are discussed in this class. Okay, so let us go to the class. So our first topic in today's class is hydroxylation at an aromatic carbon. That means substitution of hydroxy group at aromatic carbon. Okay, this is the reaction today. This is very interesting reaction because hydroxy group is a nucleophilic group. Hydroxy group is a nucleophilic group. That means in this reaction the final product is nucleophilic substituted product in aromatic ring. So what we do in this group, in the aromatic ring, the nucleophilic group is substituted at aromatic carbon. I said that it is an important and interesting reaction because hydroxy group is a nucleophilic group and the aromatic ring is an electron rich center. So aromatic compounds does not undergo nucleophilic substitution reactions. Aromatic compounds does not undergo nucleophilic substitution reactions. So we can't do directly substitution of hydroxy group in aromatic ring. By using Fanton's reagent, we can do this. The mixer of ferrous sulfate and hydrogen peroxide is known as Fanton's reagent. What is Fanton's reagent? The mixer of ferrous sulfate and hydrogen peroxide. This mixer is known as Fanton's reagent. By using this reagent, we can hydroxylate an aromatic carbon. Okay, by using Fanton's reagent, that means FeSO4 and H2O2 mixer in presence of light. Okay, by using this Fanton's reagent in presence of light, we can hydroxylate an aromatic carbon. Let us understand the mechanism of this reaction. In the first step, the hydrogen peroxide undergo homolytic cleavage to produce hydroxy free radicals. In the first step, the hydrogen peroxide undergo homolytic cleavage in presence of light to produce two OH radicals. In the first step, what is happening? The hydrogen peroxide undergo homolytic cleavage to produce two OH free radicals. This OH free radical reacts with Fe+2 ferrous ion. Okay, this ferrous ion comes from ferrous sulfate FeSO4. FeSO4 is in the form of Fe+2 and SO4-2. So here iron is in +2 oxidation state. So this Fe+2 reacts with hydroxy free radical. How can it react with hydroxy free radical? Fe+2 loses one electron to convert Fe plus 3 ion, because Fe plus 3 oxidation state is more stable than Fe plus 2. So the Fe plus 2 ion loses an electron to OH radical to produce Fe plus 3 ion. As a result, OH minus ion is formed. Here OH is in the form of free radical. It have a single electron. By taking an extra electron from Fe plus 2, it can be converted into OH minus. Okay, so in the first step, finally what will be the products are the Fe plus 2 ion from ferrous sulfate reacts with hydrogen peroxide to produce a hydroxy free radical and a hydroxide ion and Fe plus 3 ion, ferric ion. So these are the intermediates formed in the first step. What is happening in the first step? The ferrous ion reacts with hydrogen peroxide to produce a hydroxy free radical and a hydroxide ion and a ferric ion. In the second step, the hydroxy free radical formed in the first step. The hydroxy free radical formed in the first step is reacts with aromatic compound. Aromatic compound. This OH radical cleaves aromatic ring homolytically. So this OH radical will cleaves this double bond in a homolytic way. As a result, this carbon atom gets a single electron. Hence, this OH free radical adds on this carbon. So finally, we get this type of free radical. That means free radical is formed in aromatic ring. Aromatic ring. So once free radical is formed in the aromatic ring, it is stabilized by resonance structures. Okay, so here this carbon is with single electron. Automatically the adjacent carbon try to get a single electron. So the pi bond between these two carbons is cleaved in a homolytic way. Hence, this carbon gets a single electron. So, these two carbons overlap by sideway to produce this new pi bond. Finally, now this carbon gets free electron. That means single electron. So, the free radical is formed at para position. In the next resonance structure, this carbon atom tried to get free electron to stabilize this carbon free radical. Hence, this pi bond cleaved homolytically to produce carbon free radical. So, now this carbon with free electron or single electron overlap with this carbon and produces new pi bond. Since by the homolytic cleavage of this bond, finally we get a free radical again at ortho position. These are the resonance structures. So the formed free radical is stabilized by resonance structures. This is the resonance hybrid structure of the three resonance structures. That means the electron deficiency at this carbon is shared by these five carbon atoms. Okay, in the third step the aromatic free radical stabilized by the loss of H radical. So what will happen here? This is carbon with single electron. So the adjacent carbon try to get single electron. This is done by homolytic cleavage of CH bond. Okay, this CH bond homolytic cleavage produces a C radical and a H radical. This C radical and this C radical overlap to produce a new pi bond, and the H radical is comes out. Okay, in the next step, the H radical is reacts with Fe plus 3 ion, that means ferric ion, which is produced in the first step. Okay, and forms a H plus ion and Fe plus 2 ion. What is happening in this reaction? In the H radical get oxidized to H plus ion by the loss of one electron, because H plus ion is more stable than hydrogen atom. So the H radical loses an electron to produce H plus ion, and the Fe plus 3 ion gains this electron and forms Fe plus 2. Okay, so Fe plus 3 gains an electron to produce Fe plus 2. So here H radical is converted into H plus. That means H radical undergo oxidation and Fe plus 3 converts into Fe plus 2. So the Fe plus 3 ion gets reduced. Okay, H radical is oxidized and Fe plus 3 is reduced. So this H plus ion reacts with OH minus ion, which is produced in the first step. Okay, reacts both H plus ion and OH minus ion reacts to form a neutral molecule, water. Okay, this is the mechanism. So briefly, the mechanism is, in the first step, the Fe plus 2 ion reacts with hydrogen peroxide in presence of light, produces a OH radical and a hydroxide ion and a ferric ion. The OH radical produced in the first step reacts with aromatic ring and undergo addition reaction to produce a aromatic free radical. This aromatic free radical is stabilized by resonance structures, and finally this aromatic free radical forms a hydroxy substituted molecule by the loss of H radical. This H radical is oxidized by reducing Fe plus 3 ion to Fe plus 2. And finally, the H plus ion combined with OH minus ion to produce water molecule. So this is the mechanism of hydroxylation at an aromatic carbon by using Fantan's reagent. What we'll do in this reaction? We do aromatic substitution. So hydroxy group is substituted in the aromatic carbon finally. The next reaction is Reed reaction. What is Reed reaction? Chlorosulfonation of hydrocarbons is Reed reaction. Simply, chlorosulfonation of organic compounds, especially hydrocarbons, is Reed reaction. When hydrocarbon is treated with sulfur dioxide and molecular chlorine in presence of light, it produces organic sulfonyl chloride. Organic sulfonyl chloride. This reaction is known as Reed reaction. So this is for all type of hydrocarbons. Okay, hydrocarbons reacts with sulfur dioxide and molecular chlorine in presence of light produces alkyl sulfonyl chlorides. So this mechanism contains three steps. Mechanism contains three steps: initiation, propagation, termination. In the initiation step, the chlorine molecule undergo homolytic cleavage to produce two chlorine free radicals. In the initiation step, the chlorine molecule absorbs light energy and undergo homolytic cleavage to produce two chlorine free radicals. This chlorine free radical reacts with hydrocarbon and produces a organic free radical by the abstraction of hydrogen. What is happening in this step? The chlorine free radical abstracts an hydrogen from hydrocarbon and produces a organic free radical, that means carbon free radical, and forms hydrogen chloride. And the second step is propagation step. In this propagation step, the carbon free radical produced in the initiation step reacts with sulfur dioxide. That means this alkyl free radical, this organic free radical cleaves this pi bond between sulfur and oxygen in a homolytic way. Okay, so this free radical cleaves this pi bond in a homolytic way and forms bond with sulfur atom. Okay, so what is the product? R S double bond O radical. So by cleaving this pi bond, this sulfur atom gets one single electron and oxygen gets one single electron, and this carbon free radical forms bond with sulfur atom. Hence the single electron remains at the oxygen atom. So here oxy free radical is formed. So carbon free radical is converted into oxy free radical. In the next step, this oxy free radical cleaves another molecule of chlorine to produce sulfonyl chloride. Okay, this oxy free radical cleaves molecular chlorine in a homolytic way and abstracts one chlorine free radical to produce sulfonyl chloride. Hence a chlorine free radical is formed again. This is the propagation step. And finally, the termination step. In the termination step, the remaining free radicals are combined to form a neutral molecule. So whatever the free radicals are remain in the reaction, they are combined to form a stable molecules. If the chlorine free radicals remains after propagation completion, then they combine to form molecular chlorine. If there remains a chlorine free radical and alkyl free radical, they combine to form an alkyl chloride. So this is the mechanism of Reed reaction. So Reed reaction contains three steps: initiation, propagation, termination. So example for this reaction is when we take methane. So methane on reaction with sulfur dioxide and molecular chlorine in presence of light, it forms methyl sulfonyl chloride. Methyl sulfonyl chloride. And similarly, if we take benzene, and if the benzene reacts with chlorine and molecular sulfur dioxide in presence of light, it produces aryl sulfonyl chloride. Aryl sulfonyl chloride. So this is Reed reaction.